before government. No governor become governor without him. No president become president without him. It's a mafia. She's a mafia. So, fortunately, she has cancer. And because even with all the private doctors, they couldn't solve the problem of the cancer. So they did everything. I know that she's going to die. And the unfortunate thing, I think the unfortunate thing is that he has no child. So with all what he has, what is he going to do with it? Nothing. And he has cancer. So he heard that there is a man of God. That he saw him, he has watched him healing people. So, but you see, because this woman is a mafia, you know, mafia are very proud. So, but you know, he bugged himself up and said, you know, he called for a special doctor, special nurse, that he should carry him to the, with a special car, where people are calling on, coming on crutches. He came with a special car, with a special everything. Got to this program, and then begin to hear about Jesus, which I want to show you today. Begin to hear about Jesus, and you can see people getting healed. But you have to understand that if somebody is a mafia, they have their own kind of religion that they do. It's just money. So she has her own religion, but the religion could not help her. So she got here. It was a 3 days program. She got there. She loved the preaching, like the way Jesus had given. But the only thing, he doesn't want to really accept. He doesn't want to leave his religion. He said, no, I have my own religion. I cannot just now shame today. Mafia has a very hard heart. So he couldn't leave. He loved the healing, loved everything, but he couldn't love him. So when they come for healing, she came out. But she was not healed. So she went home. The second night she came again, with all the security guard and every doctors following her. Again, hear the message. If you will give your life to Christ, your sin is forgiven. Well, you have killed 10 people before that, all those sins are forgiven. But he said, I love those message, but how can I just now become a Christian? You understand? I have my own people that I control. I have people that I pay, that pray for me. I have kind of my religion. So she couldn't leave it. So when they come for healing again, she came out. She was not healed. But you can see people get in it. So he went home. The third day he came again. Then on the third day, as the message was going on, just like this morning, because you see, when you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. I believe Jesus is here this morning.
Amen.
And then God opened her eyes. God is a very loving God. He opened her eyes and she saw Jesus moving around the crowd. We touched somebody who was crippled and the cripple would rise up. Then we touched somebody who was blind. Not the preacher. Jesus touched somebody who was blind and received his sight. And then passed through her side. He sits and passed through her where she was sitting. He the person next to her. And she never got healed. So he came to her and said, you know what? I know I have my own religion. I know I have my own way of life. But I think I don't want to die of this cancer. I think this Jesus must be a very good man. Then that day, it was not time for praying for healing. But he saw it. The man of God never saw Jesus. He saw it, Jesus. But that's where God did his own thing. And then she came out and said, you know what? I'm going to give my life to Christ today. Now remember, time for prayer for healing has not started. And as soon as he made that decision, he was healed.
Amen.
Cancer disappeared.
Amen.
Jesus is the same yesterday and forevermore. Don't harden your heart. You are not smart than Jesus. He's alive forever. He has come to give you abundant life. Don't be too smart. Now I share that testimony to you, to share the testimony in the Bible with you. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
I share that testimony to you, to share the testimony in the Bible to you. Why did Jesus come? He came to heal the sick. He came to heal the sick. He came, number two, he came to forgive you your sin.
Yes.
Because of you, it is because of you that Jesus Christ came. Not because of somebody else. It is because of you. Why did he come? He came to show his love for you. He loves you. Please tell me testimony, Jesus loves you.
Jesus loves you.
Please tell them. Tell them.
Jesus loves you.
Don't die in your sin. Jesus loves you. He loves you. No matter whatever you have done, he loves you. No matter whatever you have done in the past, he loves you. He loves you. He came to give you prosperity, which you lost in the beginning. How many of you want to be rich here? Jesus Christ came because of that. He came to give you prosperity.
Amen.
He came to give you salvation, to save you. He loves you, doesn't want you to perish. He came. He came. He came. But today, you must get out of your limitation. You must get out of your bitterness. You must get out of your worry. You must get out of that lust. You must. And then, he's going to welcome you back home. He's going to welcome you back home. He came because of you, not because of anything else. He has his throne in heaven. He left his throne to come down to this earth. That's why there was That the Holy Spirit has a child. That's the only reason. We have heard about Ruth today. That's the reason why he came. He wasn't looking for anything here on earth. It's because of you and me. And we must do our part. We must do our part. Stop holding on to that small god. Those demon spirits, don't leave it. They are small spirits. Those demon spirits that you think there's something, no. The mighty God Jesus, more than that.
Amen.
There you go. They can't dwell into your life. They can't help you. Those demons, they can't help you. Jesus has an everlasting life. And he has come to give you that. Those things that are making you happy, those are demons. Those things that you think you're looking good into, those are demons. Jesus has everything you need. He has everything you need. If you will only follow him, the same miracle I've shared with you today is going to give you the same in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He's a great healer. He's a great provider. Everything on the earth and heaven was created by him. No need to waste time. It will change your life. You think what are you looking for that he doesn't have? Stop struggling. If you will follow him today, everything about you will change. Everything about you will change. The purpose of him coming. To give you life and give you more abundant. Is to give you life and will give you more abundant. Let's look at Luke chapter 5. Thank you, Jesus.